Well, Waterfront Park was made for days like this, for residents to come out and enjoy all it has to offer. But unfortunately, Louisville police say Waterfront Park and areas close by have become the targets for a certain kind of criminal.
We noticed the rise in car break-ins. It's all over the city, but predominantly in my division of Eastern Louisville.
Including those residents who live, work, and play in the areas of Waterfront Park, Brownsboro Road near the dog park, River Road around the water tower, and at parks such as Thurman Hutchins.
Since August the 1st, we've had 110 reported car break-ins, and we really felt it was important to raise the public's awareness to make sure that they lock their cars when they're unattended.
But that's what concerns police. Locked cars are not a deterrent for these criminals. Neither is a rolled-up window.
The reports that I've analyzed, over 70% of those cars are locked and the windows are being broken. So we'd like to raise the awareness and get people to store their valuables or at least take them with them.
The most common items stolen are laptops, purses, smartphones, and cash. Not much has been recovered from these thefts, but police say they have discovered a pattern of who these criminals target.
What we're seeing in a lot of these instances is folks that are working out, running in our parks, going to gyms, going to golf courses, places where your car is going to be unattended for a period of time, and you might choose to leave your purse behind.
Louisville police are increasing ATV patrols, bike patrols, and they're even installing covert cameras and undercover officers. And
we've actually set up decoy operations where we'll have a decoy vehicle with a purse inside with a tracking device.
So with LMPD's covert operations plus the public's help, they are hoping to crack down on these car break-ins. And when it was asked why there has been such a spike in these car break-ins, Louisville police say heroin has a part to play in these crimes. Here at Waterfront Park, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.